The consensus is still that the patients who are high dose therapy or dose intensive therapy fit can actually benefit with a dose intensive regimen, cytarabine coating regimen, with or without stem cell transplant consolidation in those patients, because it gives PFS in well in excess of 5 to 7 years. And so that became sort of the standard after the large randomized trial that confirmed the benefit of cytarabine. And the reason is that you achieve a deeper early CR and molecular CR in those patients. And I think this is really in mantle cell lymphoma, MRD negative status will become something really important. Where do we go to improve on this? MRD is being looked at and try to see if we can develop maintenance. And this has been looked at after the Lima trial, which didn't have our CHOP, just our DHAP, 4 cycle followed by hydrotherapy and transplant. And the data was presented at ASH with a benefit in PFS and overall survival by 3 years of maintenance of rituximab versus observation. So now the maintenance has been proven both in the elderly and younger patient. That's where the field is. And we are looking at additional ways to improve this maintenance. And there are trials looking at R-square as a maintenance versus rituximab alone to see if we can get better control of the disease. And the goal is still to obtain a more durable response, because the problem with mantle cell lymphoma is that they become chemo resistant.